The year is 58 BC, and Julius Caesar is relaxing at his palace, which I think looks something like this. He was planning an attack on the Dacians. That's right, the Dacians, not the Gauls. However, Orgetorix was migrating his people, and Caesar just wanted somebody to attack. Now, no one really knew what Orgetorix looked like. Some historians use coins to imagine what he would look like, but I would say, modern day, he looks something like this. Caesar also knew that he only had one legion guard in Gaul, so that would not be able to put up a fight against the Helvetians alone. So Caesar called upon the 7th through 10th Roman legions at the time. He knew them very well. He also began calling men from the Geneva region, a province recently subdued by Rome. Now, the 7th through 10th legion, they weren't your typical legion like these guys. No, I'm talking about 4,000 guys all like him. When the Helvetians heard that Caesar was mobilizing his troops, they sent two negotiators to work out an agreement. Eventually, the Helvetians started fleeing. They went to allied provinces of Rome, like the Allobroges, and started pillaging crops. That made Caesar pretty mad. No, I mean like really mad. Oh, what would any sane man do? Go after him. So, a group called the Tigurines, which is 1/4 of the Helvetians, they didn't cross in time, so therefore they're going to die. Or so you think. The Tigurines completely outnumber the Romans here. You can pretty much see that massive blob of Tigurines up at the top there. Romans are crossing the bridge now. And they're kind of fighting. Romans are kind of doing some work there. But what do you think will happen? That sort of happened, yeah. Okay. Any remaining Tigurines flee into the forest, far away. After the crushing Helvetian defeat, Caesar realizes that he doesn't have any more supplies, so he has to go back to a neighboring town known as Bibracte. While Caesar and his men are heading back, the Helvetians take advantage of this, and they start attacking the Romans from behind. And showtime. So, Caesar sees the attack coming, and starts sending his cavalry out into battle. His cavalry dies off, but they hold off the battle long enough so Caesar can prepare. He puts all of his legions on a hill. He creates a formation called the Triple Aces on a hill. He wants the hill because it has the high ground. The high ground usually wins. His men use pilas, or throwing sticks, that dominated close range. Caesar's men were outnumbered 2-1, and he was fighting for glory, unlike the other side, which was fighting for survival. His men were confident and well-trained, however, unlike the other side. Also, at the end of the battle, the Helvetians launched an attack from the side. It was shut down by the Romans. So, that's their little pre-battle dance. And, they look sort of confused right now, like they don't know where they're going. Ah, there you go, guys. I would really not like to get in a bar fight with all of those gingers. See the Roman soldiers throwing the pilas there. Helvetians are running away, the Romans are just chasing them down and killing them. And in case you were wondering what happened to the surprise attack from behind, well, this is it. And that Caesar kind of